It is the end of the week, end of the day, end of the show, and that means it's Friday night at the movies time, and we expect a sci-fi about a thinking robot to top the weekend box office. Arise News contributor and editor-in-chief of showbizcafe.com, Jack Rico, reviews that and some other new releases. Hello there.
How are you?
You have a big smile on your face
today. Yes, I do.
You got great plans for the weekend.
Well, you know, here in New York, it's just trying to keep warm and out of that snow. The weather's been crazy.
Enough already, but it's supposed to warm up.
It's supposed to, yeah.
But I digress. Let's talk movies.
Let's do
the first one is Chappie.
Yes. Now this, Chappie, the name Chappie comes from an expression that somebody was trying to say happy, but then they ended up saying Chappie, and that name stayed stuck to this robot, and that the whole movie is sort of based on this character. But at the end of the day, this is about a world where police are robots, and this one particular robot, this very one unique robot, is given a real conscious and the ability to think and feel.
All right, let's take a look at Chappie.
This is a new kind of life, a new step in evolution. You are Chappie.
Chappie.
Like a child, it has to learn.
What's that? Chappie's book?
Yeah, it's yours.
Chappie's got stories. Chappie's got a book.
Anything you want to do in your life, you can do. Write poetry, have original ideas.
Chappie wants to paint.
Wow.
What in the name of the Lord?
Even a robot's a big problem for me.
A thinking robot could be the end of mankind.
Real gangsters use this.
Okay, well, that just got hilarious.
Yes, there's a lot of comedy, but you know, this is basically like an homage to the 1986 film Short Circuit, where a robot, where Steven Guttenberg also starred in, but it was a robot who got electrocuted and then escaped, you know, the lab where he was in. This has almost takes on the same sort of like air and essence, except that it's actually brought into 2015. Mm-hmm. He's given a real conscious and an AI sort of. The problem with this film is a lot of them are saying that Hugh Jackman is the star of this film, where he is not. He is barely in this film, and he's actually the villain in this one. It's the star is really the robot, and when you give a mechanical source the whole sort of plot of the film, it becomes a little bit disorganized because you're expecting him to act and maybe to be dramatic at certain moments, to be very funny at others, and that robot doesn't really pull that off, unfortunately. So it really needed the help of the cast members, and they just weren't strong enough to be able to circle him with the gravitas that the show.
All right. Well, let's move on then.
Yeah, let's talk about unfinished business.
We'll talk about unfinished business, which I know you don't have any nicer things to say about this.
Unfortunately, this is one of the worst films of 2014. Vince Vaughn is a person that has a lot of talent in comedy. Unfortunately, we haven't seen the after Swingers. We really haven't seen him at his peak. And in this one, three men head out to Europe, three business partners head out to Europe, and when they're there, things go terribly awry to the point that they can't even close their deal. And this is Vince Vaughn's new project.
Well, I don't know if I really want to, but I guess let's take a look at Unfinished Business.
You're telling me we're bankrupt?
If we don't close this deal.
Well, you're the little guy taking on the big guy.
You're gonna go up against me and Dynamic Systems.
We're gonna be hard to beat. The first rule is show the client a good time.
Let's party, Apex.
Snoop Lion, probably time to pass that.
Just do it, throw it. What happened?
The second rule.
How you doing?
I'm here for a meeting.
Forget all the other rules.
You okay, Dan?
I'm not crying. That's just poison in my eye.
The good news is we nailed a big deal, and we're traveling to Germany to shake on it.
Right. The problem with this film is that it's the comedy is painfully unfunny. There's no flow, there's no texture or any inspired characters that you want to root for, and there's no creativity at all whatsoever. And unfortunately, this is another flop for Vince Vaughn that doesn't seem to have the right director putting him in the right position for him to be one of the great comedians that we have of our generation.
And I feel so bad about that. What happened to him?
You know, I just think that he's not picking the right. His agents, managers, his friends, they're not giving him the right advice because he is talented. I mean, he plays that sort of snarky, almost innocent guy, aw shucks, but with like a little devil inside. He plays that quite well. we just haven't had those great comedies to be able to put them behind.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. Yeah. Okay, well then let's quickly move on to the last one. I think you're going to be kinder to this one,
yes.
I hope. The second Exotic Marigold
Did you Hotel. See the original one?
I didn't. I still want to see it.
Well, this is sort of a romantic sexagenarian comedy where the original, it's almost like proof that a conventional story can be saved by skillful and very charming actors. In this one, the old original hotel needs now to be expanded. They need an expansion. They need to do a second one, and the whole cast comes back for all the follies that follow up.
All right, let's take a peek at the second Exotic Marigold Hotel.
The Marigold Hotel has been going properly for 8 months now. People who come and go, but there's been a core of regulars from the beginning, and Sunny takes a roll call every morning.
A most valuable precaution to ensure that nobody has died in the night.
Mrs. Evelyn Greenslade.
Here.
Douglas Ainslie.
Yeah, I'm here.
Mrs. Madge Hardcastle.
Here.
Norman Cousins and Miss Carol Parr.
Both here.
Mrs. Muriel Donnelly.
What's left?
Ladies and gentlemen,
I want to run out and see it right now.
I know. You seem to be a fan of Maggie Smith.
I'm a big fan of Maggie Smith, absolutely. I think everything she touched turned to gold.
You know, and I like Richard Gere, who now is part of the cast now. And, you know, one of the things that I really truly love, this is a really feel-good romantic comedy. It doesn't matter the age. It's about the charm and the actors and how great they fit together and this great chemistry. This is one of the surprises. I thought that the sequel was completely unnecessary. Mm-hmm. I don't know why they're even doing this. But now, with such charm and such a feel-good attitude.
It lives up to the first one because the first one's so charming.
Yep, this one does too.
All right, yay, finally some good news. Jack Rico, thank you as always.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful weekend. We'll see you next week. And that's gonna do it for us today. We thank you so much for joining us and hope you will join us again Monday for another edition of Arise America. Have a great weekend. I'm Debbie Turner Bell. Bye-bye.